It's really my pleasure to be here to attend this Vebleo seminar and give me the opportunity to talk about this project, which is here, the title, Nanomaterials Enhance the Membranes for CO2 Capture, Journey from Lab to Pre-Pilot in Field Testing. Being introduced, I'm from Norwegian University of Science and Technology. The people listed here are the main contributors to the project I'm going to present. So before I start, I want to give a few words about my group. This is a membrane research group. We call the MEMFO, like the logo here. So we located in a small town, Trondheim. This is how it looked like in the summer. And this is how look at now in the winter time. So it's as beautiful as it is. So please, if you have a chance, you're welcome to visit us. So what we do in the group, it's mainly membrane, everything about membrane. So we cover several steps from membrane material development to fabrication, to module and lab scale test and pilot scale test, also process simulation. So we have the main interest in CO2 capture or anything to do with CO2 separation. For example, CO2 removal from natural gas, flue gas, biogas, syngas, and also some other process like ammonia separation, also hydrogen purification, metal recovery, and natural gas dehydration. So that's what we normal research interests are. And for this particular talk, I'm going to focus on these keywords as highlighted here, facilitate transport with hybrid membrane. So this is the motivation back the project for CO2 capture. We are very familiar with this pretty little guy. Yeah, he's already lost a lot of his playground and gradually disappearing. His home is gone. So we really have a concern about that also for ourselves, because the global warming caused a lot of issues like very bad weather, abnormal situation happening, all because of the CO2 increasing in the atmosphere. So this is very obvious link between CO2 concentration in the atmosphere and all the global warming. So now the CO2 concentration in the atmosphere is already over 420 ppm. So if this little fellow can speak, I think what he wants to really say is, hurry up, it's urgent, please reduce CO2 emission. So that's, but it's a complete problem. So how we can do that? So if you see greenhouse gas or many CO2 emission is everywhere, it could be from the nature or from agriculture, from human activity like planes, trucks, buses, and mostly from power generation and industry, for example, cement industry, steel make, and also waste treatment. So what's good about that is CO2 from this section are really concentrated, enriched. So this is what we see if we don't treat this emission. And what we want to see in the future is we want to have the emission in, we want to have like this. So we want to, the sky is blue and what come out from the chimney is just the water and some normal gas like nitrogen, or no harmful gas out of there. So how we can do that? Scientists has made a lot of efforts these years by developing technologies to tackle this issue. Absorption, which is a very long-term technology, very mature, is widely used in this application, also absorption and the membrane separation. So membrane separation is an emerging technology compared to this another two, but this technology has some very good advantages, which is attractive. For example, has a much smaller footprint and low capital cost. You don't involve much harmful chemicals, and the energy option to capture is lower. So in this case, imagine if you are a company, if to capture CO2 costs a lot of what you gain, so you may not really need to do that. So our task is really to how we can make this happening. So to make the capture costs lower, and all the industry is willing to capture the CO2. So this is how it looks like with this cut in and get the clean gas out. In the middle is the heart of the process, or maybe we should say the lung of the process, because it's really breathing gas. So the capture CO2 is going to bury it, is we make it capture and storage. So CO2 is not going to capture it and release, but store it to take away CO2. And the most critical part is the membrane itself. The performance of membrane, if we see here, I give the mechanism of the membrane. So if you see membrane, in essentially it's a piece of like a barrier, and this barrier can separate the mixed gas. And then because of driving force, some of the gas can pass, but some are not. So we make the separation. So what kind of can gas and what can stop? It's really based on the properties like size and other physical and chemical properties. So that's how we can have the feed, and we have the permeate, in this case CO2, then we can separate the CO2. So to have a good performance of this membrane, what we need is to, what kind of performance is needed? So to make a high production, we need to have a high performance permeance. So CO2 can pass quickly. So we need to have a permeance, which is here. Also, we need to have a high selectivity or separation factor. So you have how much CO2 in and how much CO2 out. So this is what we're looking for, high selectivity, high permeance. Also high stability. Of course, for a company to make it happening, also should be easy to operate, easy to fabricate, easy to scale up. So this is all what we are looking for. But it's not an easy task. All these targets cannot come at once. So we are trying hard to how to make them happen. Then not only us, in the world, many scientists that devoted their research into this direction. So a lot of memories was made over the 20 years. These are the data collected from literature before 2020 in January. So it's the latest from yesterday, all the data collected here. But if you see, there is a line over here, we call it upper bound. This upper bound was made in 2008. After that, it's not that much up through there. It's because all the polymeric membranes are kind of subject to trade-off between the solubility and diffusivity, or made the selectivity and the permeance. These two important parameters, they have to have a trade-off. So to break through this line, to make the performance into this circle, which is interesting for industry to make the CO2 capture not that highly cost. So that's something we are looking for, how we can make that happen. So we found several ways. Our group started to look into one way, which is to take acceptable solution diffusion like this, all the gases passing the membrane, but dissolve into it and diffuse and dissolve from another side. Then the performance totally based on the solubility and the diffusivity of the gas in the polymer. And we introduce a lot of mechanism, which is called facilitated transport. So in this one, we put some functional group on the polymer itself, on the polymer bond, backbone. And for example, amino groups. So these groups may have make a CO2, amine, and water complex. So accelerate the CO2 transport with the assistance of water transport. So this type of membrane, we call it fixed set carrier membrane. So in this, we have the carrier which is fixed on the polymer. And in addition, we may also have add some small organic molecules, which is pseudophenic. We call the mobicarriers, can be added into the polymer to make this site transport mechanism stronger. So we have, at the same time, have high selectivity and the permeability or permeas. So this is approach we are going to take in this project. And except for this approach, there was another approach, which is to add up nanofillers into the polymer. Because of adding nanofillers, different shapes from 0D, which is particles, to 3D, and 1D like fibers, 2D nano seeds, and 3D porous structure. By doing this, we can change the packing of the chain in the polymer and makes the transport better. So these are two approaches. We can take one each of them, or we can combine them. So this is how the background of the project. So this project, the starting point based on a collaboration. So this project is part of this called Lalo MC Square project. It's a European Commission Horizon 2020 funded project. And the title of the project is Nanomaterials Enhanced Membrane for Carbon Capture. These are the consortium. So the consortium including a lot of research institutes and companies to produce nanoparticles, and also end users of the technology or producers of the technology. Also industry involves in the testing. And the common goal of the project is to have finally build up a good performance membrane, can break through the upper bond, and the membrane should have a simple procedure to make it. So because our goal is to make it into a truly a membrane, not a lot of paper in the literature. And we should make the technology scalable, and it should be validated in industry and approved by the industry partners. And the starting point, we have detected several polymorph phase, and we finally have 12 polymorph phase and 6 mobicarriers, which is the small pseudophenic molecules, and 9 types of nanofillers. Of course, it's not from only by my team. We have several research institutes. We have separate tasks. And the one feature of the project that we're trying to make use commercial materials as the starting materials. So then at the end, if the membrane is working, we can make it from the commercial material, so it's not dependent on the lab. It's not easy to the way from the lab, from idea into a real application like this to finally be used. So the project itself have a goal stop here. So our goal is to make the membrane we tested, we made to be validated in industry. So this is how the project ended. And we have many types of membranes developed. And finally, 2 members was selected to do their final test. Both are from my team. One is 1D material. We used the nanocellulose to put into the polymer to make the water retention higher. And another type is the 2D material. We use the graphene oxide, porous graphene oxide, makes the transport better. And the steps, you can see what we been through. So we had the membrane material optimization. So we have to have the best recipe for the performance. And then we make it into very thin, like some sub or macro thin composite membrane on flat sheet, like a flat a piece of paper. And then we also make it into hollow fiber membrane, like a very high packing density type of membrane. That's very important for industrialization. And finally, we make the module to test it in industry sites and also test for impurity duration. So this project ended at the end of 2019. And now the project also is going on with ourselves to do feasibility study. And now we are preparing to take the results further on to have a pilot demonstration project. It's ongoing. So this is the background, and then I'm going to only focus on one of the membranes we tested, which is, we call it the HFTM membrane. It's the acronym of hybrid facilitated transport membrane. And in this membrane, we add 2D graphene oxide. Because of this, he has the this structure of high aspect ratio and mechanic strength. And then also we did the modification, make it hydrophilicity to fit in the project. So for this one, you see the approach. First, we had the facility transport. We add the Lalo particles, and we also add mobile carriers. So for the facility transport part, the fixed and the mobile carriers are from, for the fixed carriers, was from polymer we call, we used, first we used polyvinylamine. There is the most, the polymer have the most abundant amino group. And we also found polyanilamine. And lately it was based on literature, we found if we make the polyanilamine with a branch connected, make it into sterically handled structure, and then the bonding with CO2 will be quick and easier. And also we add some polymer alcohol to the recipe just to make the membrane easy to produce. And based on that, the mechanism behind this is because with CO2, in presence of these amino groups, different types, and water can be easily can have produce a complex and have produced also a bicarbonate ion. This ion, instead of CO2 molecule, transports through the water region. And so the transport become quicker than gas molecule transport. So in this case, water in the flue gas or any gas streams containing water is no longer an impurity. Like other membranes, if you want to, for the separation, you have to take away water first. But for this one, water is not an impurity, but a promoter. So the promoter of water makes the separation quicker and have a high selectivity. And in, except for mobile carriers, we also have had some CO2 phenic organic small molecules like ionic liquids. We put we test many types, and finally we choose this one, imine acetate, and amino acid salts. We choose this one, which is potassium prolylate. So we have these two to test because of the interaction with CO2. And then, except for the polymer phase and the Lalo phase, which is graphene oxide phase, we had some modification. First, because if we have the Lalo seeds, it's quite a barrier for all the gases. So the permeation will be largely reduced. So we didn't just like that. We take commercial, we just bought some graphene, and then we modified it. And we also Sony, based on ultrasonic fragmentation, we made it into porous or make into smaller pieces in the hole. And also we modified the surface by grafting some more CO2 phenic molecules on the top or polymers on the top. And then the structure of the membrane, we pay attention to how we can make a graphene into a position we would like it to be. And we didn't use all the high technology, but use the most simple way to make it, and by adjust the compatibility of a polymer with the Lalo seeds, and by just simply use some, adjust the condition we made successfully, the orientation of all the seeds are totally parallel with the the membrane and made it in the optimum position for the orientation. And this is how membrane was made. It's we used the most common coating solution. So if in the future it can be commercialized, any company can take this further. So we use the bar coating technique. If you see this, so the graphene, because of the size, the ratio of the size is going to be orientated easily. And we finally got a layer of around 200 nanometers on the support material. And then also we made hollow fiber membrane by deep coating. And also by adjusting the recipe, we made the seeds in parallel coated on the surface and made it around 200 nanometers in the thickness. And this is how we made the module for the testing. And this module was made into, you see, we have the end open and this hollow fibers. So you have the fit in from outside the fiber and the out and the inside the fiber on this end, we can collect all the permeate gases. So that's how it's being tested. So in the test rig we have, so the test rig is built for particular for this kind of application because we need to supply water. So that was an important part of it is the humidify or cellular humidifiers, both in the feed side. So the feed coming in through membrane, coming out and analyzed by GC. And then we have a sweep also humidified and coming out and got from to the GC to analyze. And we have a valve here to adjust the humidity so we can control the humidity and investigate the humidity influence to the membrane. And the membrane can be made into flat sheet. So this is in this way and can be made hollow fiber to test. So these are the results. As you see, this is the upper pump we just showed you in the previous state of art. And the membrane we made all around this upper bond and some of them past the upper bond. And as we know, if we add graphene oxide in, if we don't modify it, it's just simply barrier. So we don't increase selectivity, but just reduce the permeance. But if we do some modification, for example, make it porous, so we can increase the permeability. And if we modify, then we can even increase the selectivity. That's what we have done. And then we also investigated the effect of lalo loading, the content of the graphene inside the polymer. And we found from adding 0.2 to 1%, the influence are really different. So if you see the only add 0.2%, very small amount of this lalo seed, and then the performance here significantly changed. One way is their selectivity dropped a little bit, and then another way is their permeance increased significantly. But if you have a higher loading, then you can have a higher selectivity, but a relatively lower permeance. For this case, because we are going to add more bacteria later, so we didn't take this one, but take this one. So we take the 0.2% and went further for the adding the mobile carriers. So for the case of this case, CO2 nitrogen separation, we found that the mobile carriers have negligible effect. But for the CO2 and the methane separation, there's it's like 30 or 50% higher in different cases. So finally, we found also the separation of the mobile carriers is going to benefit to high pressure. So the and conclusion is we take this 0.2% of this additive to go further for the industry test. So we made the membrane from the lab scale into the pre-pilot scale. This scale is determined by the consulting, and we take this into cement industry, and we take a strain of the flue gas directly from the chimney and test it put our membrane in and see how is CO2 going to be concentrated. And a lot of type of membrane was sent to a pilot study in the pilot scale advanced capture technology center in University of Sheffield in UK. And so it's in parallel we do two tests. And the results is here. From the lab test and from the industrial test set, we found, surprisingly, the lab scale has the data in the lab scale is not as good as in the industrial scale. So the performance in the industrial scale, you can see the performance here, it's from 1.5 to 1.9 times of the compared with the lab scale. So it's increased. And this is the final CO2 purity we can get from through the membrane. If you have 10% CO2 got in and what got out from here, we got 52%, around 50% of CO2. So this concentration of CO2 only through one stage already increased so much. So the, of course, the process usually have two stages. So we expect to be, this purity will be good enough. So this is, we also have a long-term stability test. You can see in this 15 days campaign and test, the performance was not so much changed, like the purity of CO2 even increased. And then the flux is not very much in the range of the error bar. So it's, that's, we need stability is confirmed. And then the impurity, many NOx and SOx. In this two impurity, acidic impurity, normally for most of polymeric membrane, they have irreversible changes. But for this membrane, you can see, even though we have like this 100 times higher and this one more than 1,000 times higher of the concentration of SOx and 100 times higher concentration of LOX with that intense test, we kind of permeability or CO2 impurity purity inside the separation wick is almost unchanged. And this one even increased slightly. So from this test we show, there is no much effect of this acidic impurities to the membrane stability. That's a good thing. So with these results, I would like to summarize. So the first is the presence of water. We need to promote CO2 transport through the membrane. We have confirmed this. And then we can successfully make aligned GO lysates coat into very thin layer, both on the flat sheet and hollow fiber configuration, and use very simple technology. And only 0.2% of porous GO already made a doubled enhancement in the CO2 permeation, which is significant. And then we found the industrial site not only not make it worse, but even increased the performance, 50 to 90% increased. It's mainly because, maybe because of some change in condition, for example, the temperature is higher, which is a really good sign. And also the resistance of the impurity and the long-term stability also was were documented in the campaign. So to conclude is the membrane I present here has a good potential. And also not only for this application in the cement industry, but also similar applications. For example, any CO2 removal from mixed gas streams is water vapor contain. Also in particular for small or medium sized installations, for example, biogas upgrading, and also like a small scale flue gas testing. So that's all my talk. And finally, I would like to thank this funding agent for the project, which is European Horizon 2020 project, the program. And these are the partners worked directly in the project. and also other partners in the project appreciate. Here is the Norwegian Research Council, even though they are not directly involved, but they are supporters constant to our group, and we have a very advanced memory lab, was mainly because of them. And also I would like to thank this center called Excel. It's an infrastructure supported by the Norwegian Research Council and the European Commission. And here I give the access because this research center project have open support to all the CO2 capture projects all over the world. If you want to test any of your projects, and we have the open labs for you, even we can provide some support like traveling and accommodation in the project. So you can open this link and see if you can get access to do test in our lab. And finally, here is my contact information. Yeah, so if you find something interesting, please, or some questions, please contact me. If you have ideas, collaboration, please do contact me. I'm interested in more advanced technology, especially for carbon capture. Yeah. Thank you very much for your attention.